ألا كل ما هو آت قريب، وللأرض من كل حي نصيب، وللناس حب لطول البقاء فيها، وللموت فيهم دبيب.
إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. All praise is due to Allah, the Almighty Lord, the King, the owner of the Day of Judgment. In his hands are the sustenance. In his hands all the creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever he wills, what happens. And whatever he willed it not to happen would never happen. And peace and blessings be on the last prophet and messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters in Islam, as you know, our topic today about the end of a tyrant. First, what is a tyrant? Where is an oppressor? A tyrant and an oppressor is the one who does not fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the open and in secret. The ones who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him authority over the necks of the Muslims. And he misuses that authority. He kills and he slaughters as he likes. He takes and he rips the people. And he destroys everything under his command. A tyrant, the ones who follow, the one who follows the mistakes of the Muslims and he exposes them. The tyrant who does not accept his mistakes and he would not admit to them. The tyrant is the one who brings the dancers and singers, and he keeps away the sincere ones, the ones who give him the nasiha, the advice. The tyrant is the one who elevates the status of the ones who praise him, and he keeps away the sincere monotheist. The tyrant is the one who cut off all the hands except the hands that claps to him. The tyrant is the one who breaks every pen that talks the truth and writes the truth. The tyrant is the one who silences every mouth that speaks the truth. That is the tyrant. That is the tyrant, my brothers and sisters in Islam. In history, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned many in the Quran. Fir'aun and Abu Lahab. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Namrud and other tyrants. And we know from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about Abu Jahl and other tyrants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he struck this ummah with another tyrant in year around the years of 70 Hijri, between 65 till about 80 Hijri, after the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the era of Abdul Malik ibn Marwan, there was a tyrant appointed on Wasit in Iraq, a little town in Iraq, or a small town or a small city in Iraq called Wasit. The Amir of it was sent by Abdul Malik ibn Marwan, the Khalifa of that time. This person was an extreme tyrant. He would spill blood with no hesitation. When he was appointed in Ramadan on a Friday, he woke up in the morning, got dressed, wore his amama, covered his face, and ascended the pulpit. Back then, the Amir used to give the khutbah in the main masjid of the city. The Amir of the city. He ascended the pulpit and sat silently. He wouldn't say a word. The people picked up stones, they want to stone him. Because he just sat there and he wouldn't say a word. They picked up the stones in their hands and they're waiting for him to talk. Otherwise they're going to stone him. Then a big strong man picked up stones and he was just about to stone him. This is when this tyrant stood up and said, O people of Iraq, O people of hypocrisy, O people of separation, O people of false pride, O sons of snakes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has struck you with a calamity. He sent me an amir on you. I have prepared for you my whip, but unfortunately I've lost it, and I bring my sword with me. And if I order you to exit from one door and you exit in another door, from another door, I will slaughter you one by one. And I will take your children as well, and wives as slaves to me. A tyrant that throughout the Islamic history, we haven't seen a tyrant like him. In the third day of Eid, the people were walking down the street of Wasit, practicing the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, making takbir in the open. He came out and said to them, what's this takbir? Are you trying to encourage people to follow the sunnah, or are you striking fear in their hearts? O people of Kufa, O people of Iraq, I have seen heads have ripened, and the time of picking has come, and I am the one who's going to pick it. A tyrant in the Islamic history, we haven't seen like him. This person, in his early days, he was sent to Mecca. After the death of one Khalifa, Abdullah ibn Zubayr, he saw himself as the most deserving one to be the Khalifa. Abdullah ibn Zubayr radiallahu anhu, he was the son of Asma, the sister of Aisha. Abdullah ibn Zubayr, he was one of the children of the Sahaba who grew up under the watchful eye of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Abdullah ibn Zubayr was one of the greatest scholars of Islam. He was one of the Abdullahs with an S, because there was Abdullah ibn Abbas, and Abdullah ibn Zubayr, and Abdullah ibn Umar. All of them were scholars of Islam. And he was one of those Abdullahs, well-known scholar. He took the authority and the Muslims gave him the bay'ah. But this man, this oppressor, surrounded Mecca. He erected a catapult and he bombarded Mecca until he hit the Kaaba. He struck the Kaaba with one of the missiles of that catapult. And Abdullah ibn Zubayr fought vigorously with courage. But courage on its own is not enough if there is too many people against you. If there is an army against you, Abdullah ibn Zubayr was butchered. This evil oppressor, he crucified him on the doors of Mecca so everyone can see. His body was rotting for 3 days, hanged on a piece of wood. The Asma radiallahu anha, at this time she was nearly 100 years old. She was blind. Asma is the one that unlithaqain. She used to take the food to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he was hiding in the cave with her father Abu Bakr. That's her son. She came feeling the body. She's a blind mother. She felt the pain. And she stood up to this oppressor and said to him, "Isn't it time for this martyr? To this knight, لهذا الفارس أن يستريح, to sleep in peace." He said, "Oh mother, oh our mother," she was respected, "he turned against us." She said, "Don't call me your mother. Indeed, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah will send from Thaqif two people, Allah Kadhab wa Mubir. Al-Mubir, it means a tyrant. And Al-Kadhab, we know who he is. Al-Mukhtar ibn Abdullah al-Thaqafi, who said about himself that he is a prophet. And Jibril used to descend to him. And the tyrant is you." And this is before he becomes an Amir. She could see oppression in his eyes, even though she was blind. She reminded him with this hadith. And this man, he practiced different methods of torture and killing. One day he ascended on the minbar. And while he was going up on the minbar, he was crushing it and destroying it. He stood up and said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Sulaiman, "Rabbi habli mulkan la yanbaghi ahad min ba'di." Sulaiman alayhi salatu was salam made dua to Allah, "Oh Allah, give me kingdom that is never given to anyone after me." And he criticized Sulaiman alayhi salatu was salam. He said, "Sulaiman is a hasood, envious person. He attacked the prophets, wal-iyadu billah." And he said about Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, "If I was to get him with my two hands, I will kill him myself." Why? Because Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, as you know, he had his own recitation of the Quran, because there's many modes of recitation. And because he disagreed, he said, "I would kill Abdullah ibn Mas'ud." He insulted Anas ibn Malik. At that time, Anas ibn Malik reached 100 years old. He was about 100. He entered the gathering of this oppressor. And this person, this oppressor, he abused him badly. My brothers, this oppressor was Al-Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi. His name Al-Hajjaj. Remember this name, because this name is used as an example in the Islamic history. Al-Hajjaj, there were many Muslim scholars who rebelled against him. One, his name Abdul Rahman, a Muslim leader who rebelled against him. When he, Al-Hajjaj, was given victory, he took 5,000 hostages and he slaughtered them. He took 5,000 hostages and he slaughtered them in one day. 5,000 monotheist muwahid. You want to know more? When the fitna of Al-Ash'ath, Al-Ash'ath is a person who rebelled against him, and he was supported by many Muslim scholars. Al-Hajjaj was given victory again. He took over 100,000 Muslims as hostages. And listen to tyranny, and listen to oppression, and open your ears when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to send the calamity on this ummah. Your enemy, if he was not a Muslim and he oppresses you, you know he is your enemy and he's not a Muslim. But when a Muslim oppressor oppresses you, who is from the same religion of yours, the oppression feels very bad. It is very hard to accept when it comes from a Muslim. Over 100,000 hostage under his authority. What did he do? He said to them, anyone who says, I disbelieve in Allah and in Islam, he can walk free. Anyone who rejects Islam, I would not kill him. The 100,000 replied, we will die on La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, when the glory is in the ummah, when the people do not care if they live or die, as long as they die on La ilaha illallah. And he started the slaughter. Few people backed off. And they said the words that he wanted them to say. One of them, he looked righteous. And this is narrated by Ibn Kathir, the great Muslim historian. He had the signs of righteousness. And Hashash said to him, I do not think you're going to say the word of kufr, so I'm going to kill you anyway. That man, he got scared and said, you can't trick me, Hajjaj. I am a disbeliever more than Fir'aun. He said, let me go. And he let him go. After the Hajjaj, he finished with this. The ulama said, he killed over 200,000 Muslim. 200,000 muwahid were slaughtered by him. 70,000 inside the jails. 30,000 out of them are women. One day he was walking past. He was walking past the jail cells. And that he heard them calling and saying, let us out. Listen how he replied. He replied with the same word Allah would reply on the day of judgment. When the kuffar ask Allah to set him free from Jahannam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would reply, اخسأوا فيها ولا تكلمون. Remain in it with disgrace and do not speak. This is the same words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used. He put himself and he gave himself the same authority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ulama said, when he stands on the mumbar, on the pulpit, he would speak about justice and mercy. Allahu Akbar. How many tyrants we have today? They fool us with their speeches. They will tell us about mercy to mankind with democracy and humanitarian aids. At the same time, they're slaughtering the Muslims. They lie to you. They lie to you. And the gullible Muslims, they would believe it. One of them would stand up and give a speech and says, Assalamu alaikum. And you have the puppet Muslim jump up to them. See, he said, Assalamu alaikum. Like, so what? So what if he memorizes the Quran? Al-Hajjaj, he was one of the Huffaz of the Quran, by the way. He memorized the Quran at an early age, and he was a teacher of the Quran. But Muslims are gullible. Muslims are sore losers today. They do not see the big picture behind the curtains. They do not add up 1 + 1. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strikes the ummah with calamities. But as long as the Muslims are gullible, they will always, always, always be hit on the head. This man, after he was done with the rebels and his enemies, he turned to the scholars. He said, "Now I want you to get me every scholar who speaks about me. He bad-mouths me. He says anything about me." Of course, the evildoers are many. And alhamdulillah, we always have so many hypocrites. They're happy to hand down the scholars of the ummah on a golden platter to the enemies of the ummah. You don't need to ask. Yani, you really think the people, our ulama, are hand down to the enemies because our enemy is smart or because the element of hypocrisy in our ummah? It is because of the hypocrites. You'll find the kuffar today, they know about Islam more than you, that you know about Islam. Why? Because there's always enemies of Allah who are preparing to teach him Islam and tell him, this is what this group believe in, and this is what this sect believe in, and this is what this sheikh talks about, and they record the sheikh and take it to, so they can get the sheikh in trouble. So they can get the sheikh in the newspaper. Al-Hajjaj had some of these people working for him. They said, there is a person, his name, Hutayt or Hatit al-Zayyat. Hatit al-Zayyat was a scholar at the age of 18. He used to stand up on the mimbar when he was 18. The subject of Al-Hajjaj came to his home. Yes. He said, "Yes. Wa alaykum as-salam. What's the problem?" They said, "The Hajjaj wants you." He said, "Yes. Would you give me 2 minutes? Of course, he did not open the exit door and the back door. He ran away. No. He went, showered, put the perfume, got dressed. He knew that whomever meets with the Hajjaj, he will come out dead. So he prepared himself for death. I want to talk to you about two stories of two great scholars and their debate with the Hajjaj. Yes. I want this glory inside of you to come out and see the glory when we have real scholars in this ummah. He went to the Hajjaj, stood up in front of him, shackled down. The Hajjaj, he said to him, "Are you Hatit ibn Zayyat?" He said, "Yes." He said, "So what's your story?" He said, "I promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of the Kaaba, in front of Maqam Ibrahim, 3 things. That if I was to be questioned, I will say the truth. And if I was stricken with calamity, I'll be patient. And if Allah gives me health, I will be very thankful to Allah." He said, "What do you say about me, ya Hatit?" He said, "You are one of the enemies of Allah on this earth." Straight out. "You are one of the enemies of Allah on this earth. You kill even with the smallest doubt." Hajjaj said, "Yes." "What do you say about Amir al-Mu'mineen?" Yani Abdul Malik ibn Marwan. He said, "He is more criminal than you." because he appointed you and you are a mistake from his mistakes? He said, yes. Ya Atayt, how about we compromise? We look after you and you say good things about us. Yani, let's negotiate. You have the minbar, you have the authority of the minbar, you can talk to people, say good things about me, and I will look after you. Listen to what he replied to. He replied with the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He replied as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught him, وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا إِلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا, and do not incline towards the oppressors. Allahu Akbar. He said to him, I will prevent sustenance from reaching your family on your children. Listen to the words of authority. He put himself as a Lord beside Allah. I will prevent the sustenance from reaching your family. What did this young scholar said to him? إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Indeed, Allah is the Razzaq, the one who owns the power and the most strong. My brothers, who is the Razzaq? Allah. The sustainer is Allah. Al-Ghani, the wealthy, is Allah. The king is Allah. Al-Malik is Allah. Al-Muhyi is Allah. Al-Mumit is Allah. The one who gives life is Allah. The one who takes life is Allah. Al-Aziz, the unchallengeable, is Allah. Al-Mudhil, the humiliator, is Allah. Allah is one, elevates and put down. Huwa al-Rafi', Huwa al-Khafid. He is the all-proud. Al-Mutakabbir, he is the just. He is the ruler. Huwa al-Adl, Huwa al-Hakam. When you understand this, when you live these names of Allah, you know who is Allah. And nothing will scare you anymore. And this person, this alim, knew Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He replied with, إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ. So even if you kill me, even if you prevent sustenance, it is not in your hand. It is in the hand of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who gives rizq. He said, Ya Hajjaj, know this, that if when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment gathers all the creation and he put the sins of all creation in one hand and your sins in other, your sins will be more. Straight in his face, with no fear. He said, Ya Hajjaj, Wallahi, I will not make Allah angry for your happiness, for your comfort. Allah created us to worship Him, so we would not make you happy on the expense of our religion. Al-Hashash said, take him, put him on his face, and whip him. I want the whips to rip his back. They whipped him, and they whipped him, and they whipped him. The Hajjaj looked and said, I want the flesh and the skin to come out with the whip. I want to see flesh on the whip. There is no flesh coming out on the whip. So they whipped even harder and harder. And then the Hajjaj, he said, what do you say, Ya Hatit? And this Hatit, of course, khalas, he can't talk. He cannot say anything. He's in too much pain. He said, I will never give it to you. Yani, he moved his finger with no. I will never please you. He said, Tayyib, get me the bamboo sticks. Cut them to halves. They cut them to halves. He put them in order on his back. He tied them with ropes. And he left until the wounds are dried on these bamboo sticks. And he said, pull them one by one and slowly. They pulled them one by one until no more flesh and the bones are showing. And he said, take him to the marketplace and let him die out of thirst and let the people see what would happen to anyone who disobeys me. Hutayt, he was in the marketplace, surrounded by the guards. And he would say to them, to the guards, a drink of water before I die. That's all what I'm asking for. I know I will die, but fulfill my wish and give me the drink of water. And they would not give him a drink of water. And then, whilst his soul is coming out, the people heard him say, ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. This is the predestination of the Almighty, Unchallengeable, the Most Knowledgeable Allah. And I am happy with it. And he died. That wasn't enough for the Hajjaj. He got Muhammad bin Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas, another scholar, the son of a great companion, Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas. He slaughtered him. And then he turned to Sa'id bin Jubair. Sa'id bin Jubair, he was one of the greatest scholars of Islam. He studied under Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Abdullah ibn Umar and Aisha radiallahu anha. Imagine, he studied under so many companions. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu used to say, the most knowledgeable out of my student in the Quran is Mujahid. And the most knowledgeable in issues of Hajj is Ata. And the most knowledgeable about issues of marriage and divorce is Sa'id ibn Musayyib. But Sa'id ibn Jubayr, he accumulated and encompassed all that knowledge. He was a strong scholar, a really strong scholar. He used to give fatwa while his teacher Ibn Abbas is alive. And when people come to ask Ibn Abbas, he will send him to his student, Sa'id ibn Jubayr. Sa'id ibn Jubayr, he was one of the supporters of the rebels, Al-Ash'ath. He supported him. And Al-Hajjaj sent some of his subjects to arrest Sa'id. On the way, they were fetching for Sa'id, rahimahullah. They passed by a monk. And he said to them, what are you looking for? They said, because Sa'id, when he heard his name come up, he ran away and hid. But there was a monk, he knew what he is. And he led the army of the Hajjaj to arrest him. And when the army came and saw him, they said, Assalamu alaik. They saw him prostrating. When he finished, he said, what do you want? They said, the Hajjaj wants you. He said, now, I will obey. He is the Amir, and I will obey. He went with them. They passed by that monk again. They wanted to sleep the night. It was rainy. The monk said to them, come to the monastery. Because that it is a lion and lioness, they sleep around the monastery. And I fear for you that he will harm you. The army wanted to go up and take Sa'id with them. And listen to the answer of Sa'id. Sa'id, he said, I would never sleep in the house of a mushrik. I would never sleep in the monastery. They said, but there is a lion and a lioness. He said, leave me to my Lord, he will protect me. The monk said to them, go out and watch him in case he gets attacked. Of course, at night, they were watching Sa'id. And Sa'id was praying. The lion and the lioness came. Instead of attacking him, they rubbed their heads against him in pleasure. When the monk saw this, in the morning he came down very quickly and he said, please, teach me about Islam. Teach me of what you have knowledge. And the monk became a Muslim. On the way, they reached to the town. He said to them, I am going to meet the Hajjaj and I am going to die. Of course, at this, the guards, they started to love him and incline towards him. And they can see he's a righteous man. And they know their boss, he's an oppressor. He said, leave me to my Lord. I am going to meet Munkar wa Nakir. And I'm going to meet a torment in the grave, in the angel of death. Let me prepare one night. They said, O Sa'id, we haven't seen someone like you. Please forgive us. Please pardon us in the front of Allah on the great day. Pardon us. Pardon us in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the great day of gathering. The Hajjaj, he's an oppressor and there is nothing we can do. He said, who am I? I am a small slave of Allah, a sinner. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who would forgive. I forgive you for anything. They let him go. And he said, I will come back to you in the morning. Yani he didn't run away. He went, he prayed to Allah all the night. In the morning he came to them. And he said, let's go. Of course, during the night, these people were crying. Because of the crime they have committed. Because of what they have done. Towards these righteous men. He said, let's go to the Hajjaj. Now, he entered on the Hajjaj. The Hajjaj said to him, what's your name? He said, Sa'id ibn Jubayr. Of course, Sa'id in Arabic means happy. Jubayr comes from the word Jabira, the medical plaster that you put. You know when something is broken, you put the plaster, Jabira, the way Jubayr comes from it. And listen to Hajjaj. He said, you are a sad and broken. He twisted his name. You're a sad, miserable, broken. Isn't he Sa'id, happy, Jubayr? He said to him, listen to the confidence. He said, but my mother, she knew my name better than you. And he goes, what are you talking about? You don't know my name better than my mother. He said, your mother is miserable and you are miserable. He said, the unseen, somebody else knows it. And he don't know the unseen that I'm miserable or not. Or my mother is miserable. He said, I will change your dunya to naran talavva. I'm going to change your dunya to extreme hot fire. He said, if I knew you own it, I would took you as a god. You don't own the fire. Allah owns the fire. And if I know you own the fire, I will take you as a god. He said, what do you say about Muhammad? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, he is a prophet of mercy and guidance. He said, what do you say about Ali radiallahu anhu? Is he in Jannah or hellfire? He said, if I was to enter Jannah, I will tell you who is inside of it. So I wouldn't know. He said to him, what do you say about the four rightly guarded caliphs? He said, and the other caliphs, they came after that. He said, I'm not a trustee over them. What do I know? I'm a trustee over them. Allah is the wakil, he knows. He said, who is more beloved to you? He said, the one who pleased his Lord the most. He said, who pleased his Lord the most? He said, the knowledge of that is with the one who knows the secrets and the whispers. How would I know? He said, I want you to be truthful to me. Sa'id replied, he said, even if I don't love you, I would not say a lie. Yani, subhanallah, he knows he's going to die, and he's got an answer for every word the Hajjaj say. Then the Hajjaj laughed, and everyone allowed it around him laughed, because he made someone make a joke. He just wanted to play with the nerves of Sa'id. He said, why aren't you laughing here, Sa'id? He said, what about a creation from the creation of Allah? He was created from clay, and the fire burns clay. He said, what about us? We're laughing. He said, because your hearts aren't righteous. He said, the Hajjaj ordered for some pearls and opals to be thrown in front of him. He wanted to buy him. Because if you buy someone like Sa'id to your side, you have bought a lot of people who follow Sa'id. He said to him, what's wrong with you, Ya Hajjaj? If you have collected this to protect yourself from the day of judgment, then distribute it on the Muslims. Because one fear of the fears of judgment day, all this would not benefit you. Then Al-Hajjaj ordered somebody to play the oud and the flute. The oud is like a guitar, but the Arab one, the big one. Then the Sa'id cried. He said, why are you crying, Ya Sa'id? He said, the flute, the blowing in the flute reminded me in the blowing of the horn on the life, on the day of judgment. And the oud, that oud reminded me that a tree was cut for no benefit. That tree that praises Allah is used for the disobedience of Allah. Al-Hajjaj said, woe to you, Ya Sa'id. He said, you cannot say woe to me, wail to me, because I know I am from amongst فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ, from the one who moved away from Nar. So how can you be wailing to me? He said, Ya Sa'id, choose a method of killing. Which way you want me to kill you? He said, no, you choose for yourself a method of killing. Because any way you would kill me, Allah would kill you the same way. On the day of judgment, you would die the same way. So choose for yourself a way of killing, not for me. He said, do you want me to pardon you? He said, the pardon is from Allah, but from you there is no pardon. He said, take him and kill him. Sa'id laughed out loud. Al-Hajjaj said, bring him back. What are you laughing at? You're going to die. He said, I was laughing about your courage in disobedience and how much Allah has patience. How much Allah has patience. He said, you puzzled me, Ya Sa'id. Take him and kill him. So Sa'id, he said, kill me towards the Qibla. And he said, وجهت وجهي للذي فطر السماوات والأرض حنيفا مسلما وما أنا من المشركين. I turned my face to the creator of the heavens and earth, and I incline to monotheism, and I'm not from amongst the polytheists. He said, the Hajjaj said, do not give him the pleasure of killing him towards the Qibla. Turn it to a different direction. He said, فَأَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّوا فَثَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. Anyway you turn, the face of Allah is there. So what do? He said, put him on his face and cut his head off. So they put him on his face and they cut his head off. And the one who were watching, they said the blood gushed in an unbelievable way. And the ulama said, what the executioner have said. He said, I have killed so many people with my sword. And most of them, they hardly bleed. Why? Because the fear of death in their heart will dry the blood in their veins. But this person, he looked like he never had any fear in his heart. That's why the blood was circulating and gushing. He had no fear. And when he killed him, and before he killed him, Sa'id made a dua and said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Take it off me, ya Hajjaj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would never give you the power or an authority to kill anyone after me. And after this, not long, the Hajjaj got very, very ill and sick. He would see Sa'id in his dream chasing him every night. And the Hajjaj was not able to sleep. And he would say, Mali wa mali Sa'id. What's it to me with Sa'id? I wish I never killed him. He couldn't sleep the night from the nightmares and the days from the pain of sickness. Until Al-Hajjaj was never able to kill anyone after Sa'id and died twisting and turning in his bed like a dog. Walayyadu billah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, there's so many tyrants throughout history. And there's so many of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would revenge from in this dunya. You can see Sharon. Who heard of Sharon? He's now sitting in his bed nearly what, 2 years? No one knows about him. Fir'aun drowned. And other tyrants, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took them in a vicious way to teach the people a lesson. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not let an oppressor go. And my brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah put you as a leader in your work, a leader in your home, and as someone in authority over your workers. Do not oppress, because if you would oppress, Allah will oppress, send someone to oppress you in this dunya. If it is not in your dunya, on your deathbed, if it's not on your deathbed, in the hereafter. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.